This is in Caldwell, New Jersey. Francis and Ralph and the boys came over to visit us on this particular Sunday. Boy, this was a long time ago.
That's Daddy and Aunt Francis looking at the sundial. I don't know who that is. There's Frank. That was a really pretty, pretty yard.
There is Jane. She got out there, but who's that little girl? That little girl I don't even know.
Daddy's holding Todd. It's Aunt Frances and Frank and Ralph. Ralph's got some gum.
That's the river in front of the house where Jane learned to swim. She swam with an inner tube, but she didn't realize it leaked air. So she just all of a sudden started out swimming. Her father put a leak in it. She didn't know it. Todd was born January 30th. And of course, this is just after he was born. This was still 1940, but I don't know how old he was. He couldn't have been more than a couple months old.
That was our living room in Caldwell.
But he's a hungry little kid, isn't he? Seems to be. And Aunt Frances is just waiting. She's dying to get her hands on him. She wants to hold him. I remember that dress. That merry-go-round I made was for Jane, and she played and played and played with it. And Frank and Ralph came over and tore it all apart. Oh, well, Uncle Ralph always had to have everything just right. He had a light meter, and he had a tripod.
Oh, he had cameras, and if there was a gadget, he would have it. It's the first person I ever knew that had a snowblower. Summertime, there were roses that grew over that gate. Red roses, they were beautiful. There's me.
She played nurse out there an awful lot for Frank and Ralph.
Florence Nightingale there. There's Glen Avenue. That was an old house. It was over 100 years old. It had the most beautiful staircase that went up. A big barn. We used to play in that barn. Then the city bought the barn and turned it into a firehouse.
It was a four-bedroom house. That's where Todd used to have the ghosts when he went into his room. He always called him by name and said, "I'm just one of you guys," and then he'd turn on the light, and then I was just kidding.
I had my first two-wheeled bike in that house, and I learned to, I didn't learn to ride it, but I rode it in the big cement parking area outside the barn. There's Karen, Karen's blanket. I took her up the street one time to visit my friend Nellie Beekman, and we lost the blanket. I think my father spanked me. He was so furious. There's Kimmy. Nobody'd ever heard of plastic diapers in those days. Can't hold his head up. There's Karen. She had the biggest eyes you have ever seen.
Steals across the meadows of my heart. High up in the sky, the little stars climb.
Oh, she's probably telling me to sit up. I've got my thumb in my mouth. I'm pouting.
That we're apart.
There's Kim.
You wander down the lane and far away.
Yep. Me and Todd and Kim and Karen. My dad always had a garden. You can see it behind us. God, he grew everything in that garden. Eggplant, tomatoes, cabbage, everything.
Of yesterday.
You can see it. It's right there by Todd's head. I'm pouting again.
Of the years gone by.
Look at that garden. He always had a garden.
Sometimes
I think I'm pouting because I wanted to hold Kim.
I wonder.
That's taken in Princeton.
Night, dreaming of a song, the melody.
She looks like she just started to walk.
And I am once.
Maybe it's the ground.
When our love was new. And
Karen always liked flowers.
An inspiration.
But look at those old cars. White wall tires,
now
God.
My consolation is in.
Oh yeah, Uncle Ralph always had a new car. It was usually a Buick. There's Mimo. I remember that dress. Green and white polka dots. My mom looks so young.
When stars are bright, you are in my arms. The nightingale tells his fairy tale of paradise.
I can hardly pick up Karen.
Ralph and Frank used to piggyback Todd all the time, and he just loved it. That's Jane.
Yeah. That's me, with that pointed hood. We had snow suits then. It's New Jersey.
Get up and try it again.
Here's Ralph.
And there is Uncle Ralph, and boy, he had to show off.
You always wear that hat.
Uncle Ralph was something else, wasn't he, Jane?
He was good. I remember that day.
I don't know how long it had been since he skated.
That's my Aunt Frances and my dad, lighting a cigarette. Everybody smoked. Tomatoes. I wanted one.
Karen says, no, don't do that.
Everybody's got their cigarettes. Todd was a skinny little kid then. I think when we first moved to Ridgewood, to Glen Avenue, I was in the fourth grade. And when we moved to Hillcrest Road, I was in seventh grade, maybe? No, sixth grade. Sixth grade, because I was at Willard School. That driveway, man, that was so steep. My dad built all of those stone walls and we helped him. There were three of them. The terrace. Here's Karen. There's me in the background. The white bobby socks, plaid skirt, cashmere sweater.
Yeah, this was at Christmas time. It's Jane walking around there.
And now the purple dawn of twilight.
My dad built this house.
He did?
Yep. Across the meadow, he bought the lot and built the house. And he acted as his own contractor. He used to go out there on weekends and help the guys building it, help with the framing and the stonework. And he was just always there after work and on weekends.
That we're apart.
It was a really neat house. It overlooked that whole woods in front of it. And that's an island with the tree in the middle of it. And he took that down later and just leveled it. Yep. Upper Ridgewood.
That's Ralph and Frank.
There's Ralph smoking.
The music of the years gone by.
That was your mother's first prom dress.
No, I think I just put it on so I could take a picture of it. But there had been a Christmas dance, and that's...
Boy, this was a long time ago.
Never thought my heart could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? Gotta take that sentimental journey. Sentimental journey.